Welcome students to Grow with Biology. Today we'll talk about the basic differences between animal cell and plant cell. Before moving to the difference, first we should remember that there are many similarities between a plant cell and an animal cell. Now if we talk about an animal cell, that is the basic functional unit in an animal. Similarly, plant cell is the basic functional unit of the plant. So these cells of either animal or plants will constitute to form the tissues, and then they will develop into the organs and organ system. Now when we talk about the difference between an animal cell and a plant cell, it is in the size. The plant cells are larger, whereas animal cells are smaller if we compare it with plant cells. The size of the cells range from 10 micrometer to 100 micrometer in length in plant cell, while it is up to 30 micrometers in animal cell. If we talk about the shape, animal cells shape and size vary, and they are very irregular, and it also occur in round shape. But in plant cells, the shape is similar, either rectangular or cube shaped. Now if we talk about cell wall is found in plant cell, and that cell wall helps to give the plant cell a basic strength to it. This cell wall is made up of cellulose. The basic constituent is cellulose, and it gives a rigid membrane matrix which is found only in the plant cell, and its role is to protect the cells and its contents. Whereas cell wall is basically absent in animal cell, it has the outer plasma membrane, and this plasma membrane is selectively permeable. As we are using the word selectively, it means it will only allow some of the nutrients and molecules to flow in and out. Plasma membrane is present in both the cells, plant cells or animal cells. In plant cell, it is inside the cell wall, whereas in animal cell, it is the outermost layer. It is semi-permeable in both plant cell as well as in animal cells. Cytoplasm, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum and lysosomes. We are talking about these four organelles. Cytoplasm is as usually present in both plant and animal. Ribosomes are also present because both animal cells and plant cells need to do their protein synthesis. Endoplasmic reticulum is generally of two types, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Both are present in animal and plant cells. There are lysosomes which are found in animal cells, which contains the digestive enzymes, and in plant cell. So lysosomes in animal cells have the digestive enzymes, and in plant cells it also has the plant vacuoles and the Golgi bodies, which have wherever the degradation of waste cellular products is required. Now here we talk about vacuoles, nucleus, nucleolus, centrioles and peroxisomes. First is vacuole. Now there is a difference in animal and plant cells in vacuoles. Now vacuoles are very small in size in animal cells, whereas in plant cells vacuoles are large, and it occupies 90% of the plant cell's volume. So vacuoles are small in animal cell, whereas they are large in size in plant and occupies the 90% of the cell's volume. Nucleus. The second important thing is, if we see that vacuole is present inside in the plant cell and it accumulates the major portion, so the nucleus is not present in the center in a plant cell. So nucleus has to move in the side of the cell. In one side of the vacuole there is nucleus, whereas in animal cells the vacuoles are small, so the nucleus is present in the center of the cell. Plant cell, as the centrally located there is vacuole, so the nucleus is present at the peripheral region. Nucleolus both is present in both animal and plant cell. Now come to the centrioles. Centrioles are required when we talk about cell divisions, because there are some spindle formations takes place. Now these are present in animal cells, but they are absent in plant cells. Peroxisomes, they are present in the cytoplasm in the animal cells, they are present in the cell cytoplasm in the plant cells. Both have the nearly similar functions in animal and plant cells. These are peroxisomes. Now come to microfilaments, microtubules, cytoskeleton and cytosols. Now what are microfilaments and microtubules? They are the basic they basically provide the support to the system. Now which system? If we are talking about an animal cell, they will provide the basic support to the animal cell and help in movement of the materials which are present inside the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm we have the proteins which are required at the dorsal side or in the ventral side or in the anterior posterior side. Whatever protein has been synthesized anywhere or any part of the cells, that has to be that can be moved to with the help of microfilaments and microtubule. Same function is shared in plant cell as well as in animal cells. So they help in transportation of the molecules across the cytoplasm, and they play an important role in cytokinesis. Now if we talk about cytoskeletons, they help in creating a network and it helps to maintain the cell shape. It is similar for both animals and plant cell. Now come to cytosol, which is present and which is present inside the cytoplasm, and it helps in the suspending all the cell organelles in the plant cell as well as in the animal cells. Now if we talk about microvilli, these are absent, completely absent in plant cells, while they are present in animal cells, which are basically in the intestinal lining, which helps in increasing the surface area for absorption of food. Granules are present both in animal cell as well as in plant cell. Cilia and filaments, these are absent in plant cell, whereas they are present in the animal cells. Now cilia and flagella are helping in movement of the animal cells, such as the sperms which will move to the ova. All these type of movements is done basically by the cilia and the flagella. Now if we talk about plastid is a main site for the photosynthesis, so it is specifically present in plant cell, it is absent in animal cell. Plasmodesmata is another thing which is present only in plant cells, which helps in communication and transport of materials across plant cells, whereas it is absent in animal cells. Golgi bodies, cellular nutrients, cytokinesis and osmosis. Now if we talk about Golgi bodies, they are larger and few in animal cells, whereas in plant cells they are smaller and the number is more in plant cells. In the cellular nutrients, if we talk about synthesis of cellular nutrients, they cannot synthesize amino acid, vitamins and coenzymes, that is the plant cells, where animal cells cannot synthesize the amino acid, vitamins and coenzymes, whereas plant cells can synthesize their own amino acid, vitamins and vitamins. The cytokinesis, which is that is the cell division, is by cell plate formation in plant cells, whereas in animal cells it is by constriction. Now if we talk about osmosis in a hypotonic solution, then the water molecules will get introduced inside the plant cell as well as in the animal cell. But in plant cells, they will not do the bursting because there is presence of cell wall. Whereas in animal cell, the cell will start bursting because they do not have a cell wall. So these are the basic differences between animal cell and plant cells. You can add to the Facebook group of Grow with Biology to have a look with the images of plant cells and animal cells. Thank you.